lithium ion battery is one of the secondary battery. That means reactions are reversible. Okay, reactions are reversible. That means once this discharging is over, it is possible to charge again. Okay, lithium ion battery, once discharge is completed to 0%, at that case, by connecting external power supply, it charge it to 100% is possible. Okay, that means internal reactions are reversible. Okay, so lithium ion batteries are generally, so nowadays we are using on the mobile. Okay, mobile is operated by using lithium ion batteries only. Okay, so lithium ion battery, so in this, you know, well, different type of anode metal and cathode in the inside of the battery. There are two different types of electrodes, that is called anode and cathode. So in lithium ion battery, anode is nothing but lithium cobalt oxide. Lithium cobalt oxide is called anode, LiCO2. This is called anode in lithium ion battery. Lithium cobalt oxide, anode is called lithium cobalt oxide, LiCO2. Okay, and cathode is called graphite. Cathode is made by graphite, and anode is made by lithium cobalt oxide, LiCO2. Okay, anode and cathode. And electrolyte is called potassium hydroxide. This is called potassium hydroxide, is called electrolyte. It's clear. Anode is lithium cobalt oxide, CliCO2, and the cathode is called graphite, and electrolyte is called potassium hydroxide. Okay, so this is the, so these are the different type of so parts in the lithium ion battery. Okay, potassium hydroxide, electrolyte. So inside of the batteries is like this. This is called lithium cobalt oxide. So this layer will be acting as a anode. This layer is acting as a anode. Okay. This is layer is acting as a cathode. Okay. This anode is made by lithium cobalt oxide, LiCO2, lithium cobalt oxide. And this cathode is made by graphite. Okay. So this is called a separator to provide the separation between anode and cathode. The separator is used to provide the isolation between these two. One separator is used, that's like a some small insulator. Okay, separator. So it separated the two layers. So under during discharging process, so under working principle, so try to listen. So only one concept. Lithium cobalt oxide during discharging. For example, this battery is charged to 100%. Your mobile battery is charged to 100%. Okay, during 100%, 100% charging is completed. That means when it is operating, the battery discharges, am I right? 100% to 0%. It's reducing the battery charging. During discharging condition, during discharging process, what happened? During discharging condition, so what happened is lithium cobalt oxide, is converted into lithium ions. Okay, try to concentrate. Lithium cobalt oxide is converted into lithium ions under presence of oxidation, that's called electrolyte. In the presence of electrolyte, okay, lithium cobalt is converted into lithium ions under presence of electrolyte. That is called KOH, potassium hydroxide. In the presence of KOH, lithium cobalt oxide is converted into lithium ions, and these ions are liberated on the graphite plate. Okay, understood. During discharging process, that means this mobile is 100% charging. In that case, is trying to discharge during operation. So in that case, the lithium cobalt oxide is oxidase in the presence of KOH, that is called potassium hydroxide, and is lithium cobalt oxide is converted into lithium ions, and the lithium ions are liberated on the graphite plate. Okay, once all lithium cobalt oxide is complete, lithium cobalt oxide LiCO2 is completely converted into lithium ions and is liberated on the graphite plate. Okay, discharging process completed. That means battery comes to zero position. Understood? This is called under discharging process. clear. Under discharging process, lithium ion, lithium cobalt oxide is completely converted into lithium ions in the presence of KOH, potassium hydroxide, and the lithium ions are placed on a graphite plate. Okay, so that means if all complete lithium cobalt oxide is converted into lithium ions and placed on graphite, so that is nothing but discharging process completed. Okay, 100% to 0% discharging process is completed in battery. There is no EMF inside of the battery. That is called discharging process. Okay, if you are connecting, so discharging process completed, that means 0%. So how to charge the battery? By using charger, we have to connect externally by using charger. Okay, in that case, what happened? So lithium ions are here placed, no? During discharging process, lithium cobalt oxide is converted into lithium ions. Okay, that lithium ions are placed on this graphite. That means the discharging process completed. So during charging condition, the lithium ions are converted into, again, reverse. That is called lithium cobalt oxide. Here, so how many lithium ions are placed here? Okay, how many number of lithium ions are placed? That complete lithium ions are can be converted into lithium cobalt oxide. Okay, that is nothing but a reverse reaction, is reverse. Okay, charging condition and discharging condition, lithium ions are placed on graphite plate, and charging condition, the lithium ions are converted into lithium cobalt oxide in the presence of KOH. That means reactions are reversible. Okay, lithium cobalt oxide is converted to lithium ion plus during discharge plus discharging condition. During charging condition, lithium ions are converted into the lithium cobalt oxide. That means the reactions are reversible. Okay, during discharging process like this and charging process like this. Okay, that's why it is called reactions are reversible. So in this way, this lithium ion battery is working. Okay, and then reactions are, so try to concentrate, reactions. The cell reactions are of this battery, lithium ion battery. So try to concentrate here, lithium ion battery cell reactions. So here anode is known, you know well, anode is nothing but a lithium cobalt oxide. You know well, this is converted into lithium ions and electrons, liberated electrons. Okay, during discharging process, lithium cobalt oxide is converted into the lithium ions in the presence of KOH, that is called potassium hydroxide. Okay, so Li1 minus X CO O2 and liberated electrons, so like this. And this lithium ions are placed on graphite plate during discharging process. LiCO, O2 is converted into lithium ions and liberated electrons, and that the electrons are placed on graphite, and Li plus ions and electrons placed on graphite and interact with, and is converted into lithium graphite. Lithium graphite during discharging process. So this arrow is nothing but two sides. That means reactions are reversible. Yeah, this side to this side and this side to this side. Okay, left to right and right to left is possible. Reactions are reversible. That means charging, discharging is possible. This is the called a secondary battery, under secondary battery. No? Okay, that's why reactions are reversible. This is under secondary battery. But primary battery reactions are not reversible. Only one action. Okay, only one action, that is called only discharging action. Once it's charged, okay, if it is operated, completely discharges, means there is no charging is not possible. Okay, for primary cells, but secondary cell is possible. Okay, total reaction is nothing but a little like COO2, lithium cobalt oxide plus graphite. Okay, lithium graphite. So like this, so these are the cell reactions. Okay, so cell reactions of lithium ion battery. And then coming to the some few applications of this battery, lithium ion battery. Applications of lithium ion battery. So used in mobile phones and smartphones. You know, well, lithium ion batteries used in toys, cars, and rechargeable flashlights. Rechargeable flashlights. These are the some few applications of lithium ion battery. Okay. So this is about lithium ion battery. It's completed. It's clear.